Hold up. Wait a minute.
Oh shit!
Surprise, motherfucker.
Denk nicht einmal an Schlafen. Ich bin auf dem Weg.
Yeah, boy.
No.
Good day, comrades. Today, we are going to look at one of the best Soviet anti-infantry vehicles in the game. Meet the BA-64 armored vehicle. Do you know, its armored car hull was modeled after that of the German Sonderkraft Fahrzeug 222? Yes. But don't worry, since this is the most common armored fighting vehicle to enter service in the Red Army due to being cheap and reliable. And with that said, let's get on with the review, shall we? First thing we are going to look at is its armament. It has equipped the 7.62mm EP-28 machine gun. At level 9, it can do damage of up to 99 hit points at infantry, which is not that bad at all. Damage to vehicles is 41, while to tanks is 50. Both might possibly be useful or useless when dealing with both of these units. Lastly, damage to buildings is 34. For the meantime, it is bad against it. Though what's interesting about this vehicle is that it doesn't fire automatically like other vehicles, but rather fire in bursts of bullets. Here is a comparison of burst and automatic fire. For this vehicle, the amount of burst per second is 1, which makes it fair enough at infantry combat. Range is 11, which means that you will have a hard time hitting manned anti-tank guns which outranges your vehicle. But don't worry, this vehicle comes with the cloak ability, which means that it stays hidden once deployed in battle. It is an advantage that you have to learn and able to use it properly. With the cloak ability, it also has the activate evasion ability. If you know what this means, this vehicle can dodge or evade attacks ranging from anti-tank guns to artillery pieces, with a chance of occurring at 25%. They cannot avoid small arms fire like submachine guns or pistols. I don't know why Dwemotion made that, but it would be cool to see this vehicle dodging bullet fire from infantry. At level 9, its total hit points is 939. This means that it cannot simply survive from any anti-tank gun nor tank that does more damage to vehicles. Except if it dodges the incoming fire. Lightweight vehicle means that this thing goes fast and can outpace tanks which don't have the speed to keep up with it. Because it is a rail vehicle, it can be deployed on all roads. And now we move on to the decks. I think the short dearth strategy is the perfect doctrine for this vehicle. Passive effects include the ability for this unit to lay mines, which may prove useful against infantry and vehicles. Another passive effect is to deal explosive damage once destroyed. This may last up to 4 seconds, when the vehicle will blow up and deal damage to surrounding units. The higher the level of the unit, the more damage the explosion will deal with enemy units. Now for some advice. Remember on what I told you about the passive effects. Both of them may prove useful on what I'm about to tell you right now. Use it as a suicide vehicle. Since it has the cloak ability, your unit is undetectable to enemy bunkers, and you have the advantage of surprise. Remember that your vehicle has mines. Place it near the rear roads of any bunker. Don't worry, once the vehicle explodes, it won't affect your mines. This may prove useful when the enemy deploys an infantry unit, which in turn would destroy it immediately or damage it badly. That's it for today's unit review. As always, I will see you tomorrow, commanders. Make sure to like the video, leave a comment, and subscribe to the channel.